please step up to the congregation.
Yes, you are a donkey.
Oh, Donald Trump. When Mexico sends its people, they're not sending their best. They're bringing drugs. They're bringing crime. They're rapists.
He's a jackass.
Donkey of the Day for Wednesday, May 6th, goes to the celebrity-in-chief, Mr. Dope 45, Donald J. Trump. I don't know what kind of student the 45th president of the United States of America was, but I guarantee in school, he hated science, okay? He didn't like physics, chemistry, biology, nothing, okay? Formal sciences, natural sciences, social sciences. He didn't like God bodies in New York asking, what's the science? Donald J. Trump hates science, and his disdain for science is showing once again because yesterday the president announced that he will be winding down the White House coronavirus task force. Yep. Let's go to CNN for the report, please.
The doctor is saying that there might be a recurrence of coronavirus in the fall. Can you just explain why is now the time to wind down that task force?
Because we can't keep our country closed for the next 5 years. You know, you could say there might be a recurrence, and there might be. And, you know, most doctors or some doctors say that it will happen, and it'll be a flame, and we're going to put the flame out. We've learned a lot. You see what it does, especially for people over a certain age. And we're saying that people that are over 60, 65, but over 60, we're even saying, stay back for a while. At the same time, with young children and children, we'd like to see the schools open early next season and on time.
But don't you want your advisors to keep looking at this closely the way
well,
you have?
We are looking at it very closely. I'm viewing our great citizens of this country as warriors. And yes, will some people be affected? Yes. Will some people be affected badly? Yes. But we have to get our country open.
Now, this news is coming out as the rate of the country's daily new coronavirus cases and reported deaths are plateauing, according to the Johns Hopkins University Coronavirus Research Center. And also, it's a model created by the Institute for Health Metrics and Evaluation at the University of Washington that projects a doubling of U.S. deaths to 134,000 by August 4th. OK, that's an increased daily death toll. All while governors urged on by Trump relax social distancing measures. Now, who out there has ever had chlamydia? Raise your hands. No volunteers. OK, never mind chlamydia. Who out there has ever had some type of bacterial infection?
Envy,
you had jock itch once. Pink eye. I think pink eye does count.
Why are you talking about my jock itch, boo? Yes, I did have jock itch when I used to ride my motorcycle.
I don't know if jock itch is a bacterial infection. I think pink eye is, okay? But the moral of the story is whether it's pink eye, syphilis, meningitis, okay, you don't have to tell us what it was, but if you've ever had a bacterial infection, then you know when you have a bacterial infection, the doctor always says if you're taking antibiotics, don't stop taking them until the pill vial is empty, even if you feel better. Now, some doctors have pushed back on that and said taking drugs when you aren't sick anymore simply gives the hordes of bacteria in and on your body more incentive to evolve to evade the drugs. So the next time you have an infection, they may not work. Guess what? My whole life, if I have a problem and there's a solution to that problem, if I'm using said solution and it makes the problem go away, but I still have more of the solution, I'm going to keep that solution around until I know without a shadow of a doubt that the problem is in my rear view, period. As far as I'm concerned, we are still in the midst of a global pandemic, a pandemic that was fueled by the arrogance and ego of Donald J. Trump, the same person who eliminated the job of coordinating a national pandemic response. That job is now being done by Trump's son-in-law, Jared Kushner, the same president who told us back in February that Democrats were politicizing the deadly coronavirus and claimed that the outbreak is their new hoax. This is the same person who is now winding down the coronavirus task force. And I have to ask one simple question. Why? At a time like this, when Trump is anxious to reopen the country and pressure is causing governors to reopen the country, when his administration's internal model has projected to rise up to 3,000 daily deaths, isn't this the time to keep the coronavirus task force together? Simply because you don't know what's going to happen, right? Shouldn't you have the experts on your side? The problem with Trump isn't just what he doesn't know, it's what he isn't willing to learn, okay? He should have learned from his past mistakes on how he handled this situation. Every poor decision he made has led us to this point. And now he's about to send the country on another dummy mission. Okay, listen, America, your government doesn't care about you. Well, not all of you. Okay, let's go back to what he said. Let's play that little part of the clip, please.
You see what it does, especially for people over a certain age. And we're saying that people that are over 60, 65, but over 60, we're even saying, stay back for a while. At the same time, with young children and children, we'd like to see the schools open early next season.
Mr. President, how can you say that you see what it does to people over a certain age, right? people 60 and up, but then say you want to see the schools open early next season. You do realize kids can be asymptomatic and bring the disease home to their parents, grandparents, aunts, uncles, all over the age of 60. I mean, it's just some common sense, okay? But once again, America, your president and this administration doesn't give a damn about you. We the people are eggs, and the economy is an omelet. And if a few eggs get broken to make the omelet, fine, okay? It's majority of the darker color eggs anyway. The white eggs are cool, right? Okay, good. What are you talking about, Charlemagne? Oh, Uncle Charlotte is rambling again. Dark eggs, brown eggs, white eggs. I'm talking about the fact that the CDC released data showing coronavirus is impacting black people the worst. Oh, yes, 52% of diagnoses and 58% of coronavirus deaths nationally are black. You have to know they really don't give a damn. Okay, not at all. Those numbers excite them. All right. So my people, please don't be reckless. Don't be careless. Don't be careless. Okay. Just because Donald Trump and the White House are winding down the coronavirus task force, don't you wind down on protecting yourself. Okay. Make sure you got your mask, your hand sanitizer. Make sure you're washing your hands. Make sure you're washing your ass. Social distancing. Just doing what you have to do to protect yourself. Because if you haven't learned yet, this country will never protect you. And by you, I mean your black ass. Please give Donald J. Trump the biggest hee-haw. Matter of fact, let Kathy Griffin give Donald Trump the biggest hee-haw.
Please give this giant jar of mayo the biggest hee-haw.
Well, thank you for that donkey today.
Yes, indeed.
Donkey Today is brought to you by the Law Office of Michael S. Lamonsoff. Don't be a donkey. Dial #250 on your cell and say the bull if you've been hurt in a construction accident. That's #250 from your cell and say the bull.